So our first topic here is about first global refugee forum. Again, this organization or this dialogue or this meeting is very much important for this year exam. And why this is very much important for this year exam? Because this global refugee forum is first of such a reform. Okay. इस तरह का पहला एक फोरम बना है, ओके, इंटरनेशनल फोरम बना है टू डील विद द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ ग्लोबल रिफ्यूजीज एंड दैट इज व्हाई दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक फर्स्ट ग्लोबल रिफ्यूजी फोरम और ग्लोबल रिफ्यूजी फोरम इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर दिस ईयर एग्जाम. सो यू सी व्हाट इट इज द फर्स्ट मेजर मीटिंग ऑन रिफ्यूजीज ऑफ द 21st सेंचुरी वॉज जॉइंटली होस्टेड बाय द UNHCR. It is basically United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, this international organization UNHCR, and UN Refugee Agency, and the government of Switzerland. So these three bodies, UNHCR, UN Refugee Agency, and the government of Switzerland, jointly hosted this particular meeting of this global refugee forum. And this new forum has been created now, and it's an international forum. So this forum, as the name suggests, this is basically deal with refugees. So it aimed to discuss and debate the response of countries to the global refugee situation. It was the first ever meeting of the global refugee forum. This meeting was held in Geneva, Switzerland. So now we'll see what are the key points of this particular forum. According to UNHCR, the first GRF is being held when the number of refugees has risen to over 25 million people worldwide. So they are saying that the number of refugees has been increased tremendously for past few years. And that is why there was a need to protect these refugees, okay? Because in the hosted countries, where these refugees receives, okay, where these refugees reach, these countries are not paying the adequate attention, and in fact, that is a burden for that country also. यदि मान लो किसी country में refugees आते हैं, तो वो उस country के लिए भी burden है, refugees के लिए बिल्कुल उनको भी अपने rights नहीं मिल रहे हैं. So it's not a national specific problem, it's an international problem, okay? So that is why we need to deal with the situation of refugee, this kind of forum was needed, okay? So the GRF meeting, Global Refugee Forum meeting, will be held every 4 years at the ministerial level. So ye bhi yaad rakhna hai ki ye meeting har 4 saal baad hua karegi, because this new forum has been created, that is Global Refugee Forum. And that meeting will be at the ministerial level and not at the secretarial level. This is the again point that you need to remember. Now the first GRF, this first meeting of the Global Refugee Forum focused on 6 areas. And what are those 6 areas? First is the burden and responsibility sharing. As I told you that it's a problem of the host country also, because if जैसे कि रोहिंग्या का एग्जांपल लेते हैं हम लोग, ओके, बिकॉज जैसे कि रोहिंग्या म्यांमार से बेसिकली दे मूव्ड टू बांग्लादेश, ओके, ऑब्वियसली बिकॉज जीनोसाइड वाज अकर्ड एट द म्यांमार एंड दैट इज व्हाई दे मूव टू द बांग्लादेश कॉक्स बाजार. सो एंड दैट इज व्हाई इट वाज नो मे बी अबाउट 10 लाख अराउंड मोर देन 6 लाख रिफ्यूजीज वर देयर इन बांग्लादेश. So now this was a burden on the Bangladesh also, and that is why the whole international community need to do for this kind of refugees. Okay, if this Bangladesh is showing its scarcity, courtesy, then it doesn't mean that it should be punished. The Bangladesh should be punished. Obviously, the whole international community should work for to help this Rohingyas, okay, these refugees. So that is why this burden and responsibility sharing, that this burden will be shared by everyone, and not only the burden should be shared by internationally with all countries In fact, the burden should be shared by the private sector also. Okay, because private sector can do also things like they can provide employment to refugees. Okay, so obviously it's a shared responsibility. So this is our first aim or first focus of this particular meeting. And second is the education. We need to provide the education to everyone, to refugees. Okay, and about the refugees laws, and we need to protect them, these refugees, by providing the education also. We need to provide them jobs and livelihoods. We need to secure their energy and infrastructure. And for example, that we need to provide them electricity connection. We need to provide them good houses, okay, where they can reside, and various other solutions. And to protect and to protect them, okay, there's a protection capacity. Okay, so these are the basically six focus areas of this particular first GRF. So now the next feature is that it intended to present an opportunity for UN member states and other stakeholders to announce action plans and pledges towards meeting objectives such as easing the burden on the host country, which we were talking about. Okay, that we need to reduce the burden of the host country. Host country means the country which is receiving refugees. Enhancing refugee self-reliance, that we need to make them empowered so that they could be self-reliant. They could not be dependent on others. And how we can make them self-reliant? Obviously, by providing them education and livelihood and infrastructure that they are needed. Expanding access to third country solutions. Okay, third country solutions means that other countries need to work to provide them the facilities, various facilities, and supporting conditions in countries of origin for return in safety and dignity. जैसे कि अब इसका फाइनल सोल्यूशन क्या हुआ था, रोहिंग्या का जो केस था उसका फाइनल सोल्यूशन ये हुआ था कि दैट दीज रिफ्यूजीज, दीज रोहिंग्यास विल बी मूव्ड फर्दर टू देयर ओरिजिन कंट्री, दैट इज द म्यांमार. और फिर म्यांमार में बेसिकली वहां पर हाउसेज बनाना था, ओके, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर क्रिएट करना था ताकि वहां पर लोग ये दोबारा सब जाए तो अच्छे से रह सके. फॉर दैट मेनी कंट्रीज हेल्प, इंटरनेशनल मेनी कंट्रीज हेल्प, इनफैक्ट नॉट ओनली कंट्रीज, इनफैक्ट दीज डेवलपमेंट बैंक्स ऑल्सो हेल्प, लाइक वर्ल्ड बैंक, एशियन डेवलपमेंट, दीज बैंक्स ऑल्सो हेल्प in these kind of situations. So obviously India also helped to create these houses. Okay, India has also given some amount, okay, to Myanmar. So that is why, so the our final aim is to provide conditions for these refugees in their origin country so that they could live in safety and dignity. And steps taken in this meeting included of about $3 billion from states, $250 million from the private sector, with promise to provide around 15,000 jobs to refugees, and several billion dollars from developmental banks. So this much pledges were there in this particular meeting, that various states will provide this much amount, likewise private sector will provide this much amount along with the 15,000 jobs, and there will be a funding from the developmental banks also so that we could relocate these refugees. So now this in December 2018, ab ek saal pehle ki baat karte hain isse hum log, jab ye meeting hui thi 2019 mein ye meeting hui thi. So in December 2018 this global compact on refugees was adopted by the United Nations Assembly. It is an effort to improve the international refugee response, so this forum implements the compact. So 2018 mein ye ek agreement sign hua tha United Nations ke andar, its name was Global Compact on Refugees. So isi ko implement humne kiya hai by creating GRF, Global Refugee Forum. Okay, so ye agreement sign hua tha December 2018 mein. So ye bhi exam mein statement aa sakti hai that this agreement implements the Global Compact on Refugees. That statement will be correct. In fact, it was proposed by the USA. Okay, this compact. So analysis देखते हैं हम लोग अभी. And this is more important because exam में tricky questions आ सकते हैं, tricky statements आ सकते हैं about this global refugee forum. So this forum was convened by these countries: Costa Rica, Ethiopia, Germany, Turkey, and Pakistan. अभी मैंने आपको यहाँ पर पाकिस्तान को double underline किए. And why I made this double underline is Pakistan because it is a specific feature of this global refugee forum. बहुत कम सुनने को मिलता है कि पाकिस्तान ने कोई international meeting को convene किया हो. Okay. So it's just an isolated example. इसीलिए ये मैं आपको basically ये topic और important हो जाता है इस साल के. And इसमें एक dramatic talks भी हुई थी इस GRF में, यदि आप लोगों को याद हो तो. किसी को याद है क्या हुआ था इस टाइम? एनीबॉडी?
तो सिटीजनशिप अमेंडमेंट बिल,
राइट. सो दिस पाकिस्तान प्राइम मिनिस्टर इमरान खान, ओके, क्रिटिसाइज्ड इंडिया फॉर यूज ऑफ सीएए, ओके, एंड द रिफ्यूजी प्रॉब्लम इन द जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, नॉट रिफ्यूजी, दिस प्रॉब्लम इन द जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, ओके. सो this Pakistan PM used this platform global refugee forum GRF to criticize India. So and obviously India replied with its hard hand. That's a different thing. Okay, so ye yaad rakhna aap logo ko that this forum was convened by the Costa Rica, Ethiopia, Germany, Turkey and Pakistan. The five countries ne convene kiya tha. So exam mein bhi statement mein India aa jaye yahan pe, okay, but remember one thing that this is convened by these five countries. So Pakistan's PM talked about its contribution towards Afghan refugees. So उन्होंने बात की कि yes, हम लोग अफगान refugees के लिए बहुत सारा contribution करते. He said that Pakistan is hosting thousands of Afghan refugees. In fact, exact number given by this UNHCR that there are 1.4 million registered Afghans in Pakistan. Okay. That means 14 lakh Afghans in Pakistan. So Pakistan said that we are hosting this much of Afghan refugees in our country for past 40 years. Okay. And after making these stories, then this Pakistan Prime Minister criticized India. Okay. That's a different thing that these Afghan refugees they most of them are made Taliban in Pakistan. That's a different thing. Yes, बाकी story हम जानते हैं because we already read about the Taliban. So he used this, means the Pakistan Prime Minister used this platform to criticize role of India in passage of CAA. Our External Affairs Ministry negated these claims and made counter claims in security of minorities in Pakistan. India also gave an example of treatment of Pakistan to East Pakistan in 1971. So India ने basically 1971 का example देते हुए कि East Pakistan या जिसको भी Bangladesh के नाम से जानते हैं हम लोग, तो उसके against West Pakistan ने किस तरह से treatment किया था. So India used this particular example that how Pakistan treat with their minority population. Okay, and fit we have n number of cases that in Pakistan, in fact in Corona case also, that there are claims that Pakistan is not providing adequate amenities to the minority people, specifically Hindu people, okay, in this Corona epidemic. Now for India, that means how this GRF put an impact on India. Okay. So इसको देखना आप लोगों ने, ये कुछ statements आ सकती हैं, कुछ अलग से similar, basically. रिफ्यूजी के ऊपर, रिफ्यूजी इशू के ऊपर ही बेसिकली कुछ चीजें जो कि मुझे लगता है एग्जाम में आ सकती हैं इस इशू के साथ. दैट इज दैट इंडिया इज नॉट ए सिग्नेटरी टू द 1951 कन्वेंशन ऑन रिफ्यूजीज और द 1967 प्रोटोकॉल रिलेटिंग टू द स्टेटस ऑफ रिफ्यूजीज. सो दीज आर अगेन इंटरनेशनल कन्वेंशंस और इंटरनेशनल प्रोटोकॉल. 1951 कन्वेंशन ऑन रिफ्यूजीज एंड 1967 प्रोटोकॉल अगेन अबाउट रिफ्यूजीज, स्टेटस ऑफ रिफ्यूजीज. So it is not a signatory to this particular convention and protocol. Okay. That means India do not want to bind with these Fiji protocols. Why it could be? Kya reason ho sakta hai? Yes. Okay. So भी आपको पता लग जाएगा. Because briefly आपको अभी यहाँ पर बता देता हूँ, then because हम भी थोड़े डिटेल में पढ़ने वाले हम लोग. Okay. Because India deal with these cases, refugee cases by case, जैसे कि जो तिब्बतन refugees है, हम उसको बाहर निकालना नहीं चाहते. Okay, हमारी countries, उनको हम protect भी करते हैं, in fact. बट देर आर अदर रिफ्यूजीज, जैसे कि इस्लामिक जो बेसिकली जो एक्सट्रीमिस्ट ग्रुप्स होते हैं, लाइक इट्स ए इंटेलिजेंस रिपोर्ट दैट दिस रोहिंग्या दैट आर प्रेजेंट इन इंडिया एंड इट्स पॉपुलेशन इज मोर देन 50,000. सो द रोहिंग्या विच आर प्रेजेंट इन इंडिया, दे आर इंडल्ज्ड इन द एंटी इंडिया एक्टिविटीज, एंटी नेशनल एक्टिविटीज, एंड दैट इज वाई वी डील दीज रिफ्यूजीज केस बाय केस. दैट मीन्स If we have signed this 1950, if we would sign this 1951 Convention on 1967 Protocol, then we will be bound to protect these refugees. Okay, but we want to exile these Rohingyas from our country because there is an intelligence report that these Rohingyas are indulged in the anti-national activities, and that is why India is not a signatory to this particular Convention or Protocol. So India does not have a separate statute for refugees, and until now has been dealing with refugees on a case by case basis. According to Home Ministry, there are 54,000 Rohingya refugees living in India, both registered and unregistered. According to the Bureau of Immigration data, India sent back 330 Pakistanis and 1770 Bangladeshis between 2015 and 18. See, because we are returning these refugees to their origin countries. Okay. So in 2017, in an affidavit filed before the Supreme Court, the government said that the presence of Rohingya in the country has serious national security concerns, as inputs suggest that immigrants has Pak-based terror groups. Okay. So while you are writing in your mains examination, you can put these kind of facts. Okay, okay. You cannot make your own statement ki aisa ho jana chahiye. Okay, international relations mein khas kar aap logo yaad rakhna, international relations mein humko kuch facts use karne hain, jaise ki jo bhi countries beech mein agreement sign hai uske base ke upar baat karni hai, या कुछ भी कुछ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स से कुछ बोला तो उसके उसको कोट करके बेसिकली बात करनी. ओके, सो लाइकवाइज इफ यू वांट टू क्रिटिसाइज दिस रोहिंग्यास और यू वांट टू टेक अ स्टैंड दैट दिस सम ऑफ दिस ऑब्वियसली व्हाई वी आर टेकिंग द केस बाय केस ऑफ दिस रिफ्यूजीज, डेफिनेटली यू कैन पुट दिस काइंड ऑफ फैक्ट्स दैट आवर गवर्नमेंट हैज फाइल्ड एन एफिडेविट इन द सुप्रीम कोर्ट बाय सेइंग दैट रोहिंग्या इन द कंट्री हैव सीरियस नेशनल सिक्योरिटी कंसर्न्स and they have linked with the Pak-based terror groups.
Thanks for watching our video. Please like, share and subscribe.